We are going to be recording our ostinato, our rhythmic ostinato. So that means we need some drums. So we're going to right click underneath our instruments and add a new software instrument track. From here, we're going to go to our drum kit and choose any one of these drum kits. We want an acoustic drum kit because that is the sound that we're after. Remember, we're doing an orchestra and we don't need a full drum kit. We just need a snare drum. So if you do want to be really specific, you can go and choose specifically snare drums should you wish. From here, if you can't already see this at the bottom, what you can do is you're going to right click and create pattern region. So for drums, we have pattern regions, and for all other instruments, we have MIDI regions. So let's create a pattern region for our drums. And you can see here, this is one bar. Okay, so we're going to talk about tar, TT, and tika tika. We use these to help talk about our rhythms. And if we go into our snare center, we do tar, 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 tar. So that is four tars, that is one bar. So even though there are lots of notes in this section here, this means it's just split into tika tika for each section. So this is just one bar. Now, if we look up here, it's spread across four bars, and that's just because it's repeated. If we run this back, that's fine. You can see it's not just four. We go one, two, three, four, five, six. There's lots of them here. It's not just the four that I've got here. And so if we listen to that, that's ta 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 ta. That sounds like this. But that doesn't sound particularly interesting. So maybe we go ta and then TT. So now we've got two bits in here, but make sure it's not right next to each other. That'll be a tika, but we want a space in between to mean it's a TT. Okay, and I think I'm gonna add a tika tika at the end. So now that's ta, TT, ta, tika tika. Okay, let's have a listen to what that sounds like. Now that sounds quite nice, but our velocity, we're going to change it to velocity and value. There's lots of other things we can do in here and have a play with. We're going to focus on velocity for now. So we've chosen and gone over to our velocity. And velocity is how hard the drum is being hit. So if you hit it really hard, that's going to go up to 127. That's the max. If you hit it really lightly, you can hear that's not being hit very much at all. And its default is 100. So I want my key beats, so that's the first beat, that's going to be quite loud at 100. And then these two I want to be slightly quieter. And then this one I want nice and loud. And I want to build up to this final beat. And what I've done there is I've literally just clicked and then dragged my line. And you can do that across the whole thing. You can click and drag your line to make that. So now let's listen to that. What that does, it makes it just sound that much more real and live, as if you're playing a real snare by adding those in there.